So the story goes like this. Years ago, when my sons were little boys, their dad took them out to play in the snow. And this particular day, Micah, my middle son, came home with the snowball. When they all walked in, I noticed the snowball. Micah was so self-assured and so proud of the snowball he made. He didn't use it. He brought it home like it was a snowball statue. And my husband said, don't say anything. Micah was so attached to it. So they put it in the freezer. Okay? So every time we would go grocery shopping, we'd have to maneuver the groceries into the freezer around the snowball. And sometimes it was difficult. And Micah would be there and we'd say, Micah, let's just throw this away so we can make more room. And Micah, no, don't throw my snowball away. And for some reason, his self-assuredness and his connection to the snowball was just so admirable, we yielded as parents. Yeah, we punked out. I was getting weary because I was the one doing the cooking and putting things away, and I was really getting quite tired of being intimidated and not moving the snowball because this little kid wanted the snowball. So you know what? On the hottest day of the year, as it was reported as such, and it was record-breaking heat, and it was reported as such, and we had about a period of that, I convinced Micah to take his snowball down to the news station and donate it to say, like, from the coldest day to the hottest day of the year. And Micah went along with the story. It was working. He let me take the snowball out of the freezer. And we got into the car after putting it in the small bag with ice around it. And we took it to one of the local news stations in the city where I lived. They were happy to receive it because I called them ahead of time. And later that evening, live on TV, they mentioned Micah's name and they showed the snowball and they connected it to the weather for that day. And Micah smiled. And I got the snowball out of my freezer. Sometimes we need to get rid of things that we might have needed. A crutch. You know, a practice, a hobby, a habit. It was needful at the time. We were somehow connected to it. But sometimes it impacts the people around us. And we need to consider making room for other things. Yeah. But we first have to admit, we got a snowball. We got to own up to that we brought in to our lives. That we stored away. We just can't say it's not there and we're done with it. We've got to do something. You've got to do something. You got to open up that, like in this case, the refrigerator door, take out that snowball, and purposefully get rid of it. And in this case, you know what we did. So sometimes you have to memorialize the occasion so it's special to it. So you attach letting go, just like they did in the Old Testament. When they took the sins of the people and they killed the lamb and then smeared it on the scapegoat and sent him out. Yeah. Sometimes we have to attach something special so that we can just draw in all of those feelings that we had, place it on that thing, and get rid of it. One time in this movie called Forgiveness, when the family had lost their daughter who had jumped out of the car and ran and got hit by a truck driver, and all of those individuals had to go through some process of forgiveness, some process of letting go, because it is a process. It's just not a poof, faith, presto, change-o, hocus-pocus thing. Sometimes it is a process. But when it came up in the little boy's spirit, what he had been holding on to, that they were fighting over a toy, and that he threw the toy out, and she ran, and the little girl opened the door and ran for that toy. The mother took another toy, and she said, "This is not your fault," to her son. She said, "That's the toy's fault." She had to place that guilt, place the shame, place the memory. She had to do something with it. And she took that toy, and she threw it away. She threw it in the yard, and he ran over it. And he just stomped on that, and he cried, and he stomped on that and cried, because sometimes in the letting go process, you have to admit what it is, and you have to cleanse and flush. And it doesn't mean that you're not moving in faith, and it doesn't mean that you're not healthy mentally. Actually, you're getting closer to a place of mental wellness. Mental wellness, because you're getting out of the hellness that was hidden, you know, in our inner man. That's what God says, you know, no man knows the heart, you know. It's deceitfully wicked. It's always hiding in a crack in a crevice. It's hiding something from you. You got a hidden self and a known self and a blind self and an unknown self. Because sometimes it takes time to yourself be true. It takes time to study, to show yourself approved, and then the Holy Spirit brings truth to your inward parts to undo the stuff the world did, the stuff your family did, the stuff you did, and develop and making a personality that did not reflect the image of God. And God has to let you let go of things, and he shines his light, and he's a tender surgeon. He's waiting for you to see it, to name it, to take authority over it, and give it to him. And sometimes it might happen in a day or two, but most times, somewhere over the process, in your lifetime, yeah, you'll always be learning to yield, to give, to surrender all to Jesus. It does not happen on your day of salvation. Yeah, that'd be nice, yeah. You know, some things we get the victory over the dominion habit of sin. We're redeemed from the curse of the law. But there's a process of renewing your mind. There's a process of allowing our hearts to be cleansed by Jesus. It's a process of dying to ourself, crucifying self, renewing. It is a process. And it's never ending. It'll be right up to the time we die. So be encouraged. As we celebrate the holidays and you're getting new stuff in, you might be reminded of something old that you stored away and had its purpose. It had its day. It had its season. But this is a new season and this is a new day. And even if you move towards the process of beginning to cleanse it away, like you're walking toward that refrigerator, you're thinking about where you're going to take that thing to. Think about, is your all on the altar of sacrifice lane, because God gave us his all. Surrender all. Let it go. Let it go. Let some stuff go. And don't shame yourself and condemn yourself and let anybody talk about you and let anybody determine what your process should be. God got this. He's willing to will in you. And he's showing you the places that you didn't have the courage to, that you hid from yourself. Maybe it was post-traumatic stress, bullying, whatever it is. Maybe some of the stuff you deflected on others. And God understands. And he's waiting. And he will take you to that place inside of you to be free. Because he is there inside of you when you accept him as your Lord and Savior to will his will. To allow the sanctification that he's given you to be a personal experience to set you apart for the master's use. And you've got to let some things go for that. Because if you got something in your hand, you don't have a place for the new stuff to begin again. Be encouraged in your walk. Be encouraged in your journey. Know that you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. You can let go of the pain. You can let go of the shame. You can say, God, I believe. Help thou my unbelief. Faith is not just for salvation, but faith is for receiving what God said about you. You are a new creature in Christ. You're the head and not the tail, above and not beneath, first and never last. Sometimes faith is just accepting what is said about you. Now know this, what he said about Christ is what he said about you. So receive Christ in you. Receive the God in you, hope of glory as you come in. Emmanuel, God with us and God in us. God revealed in us. Why? So the world will know that he has come. Your life is about someone else having the opportunity for salvation. That's what it's all about. What's it all about? It's about love. It's a love thing. And God wants a love through you. But you've got to love you. You got to let go of the things and filter out your love of you and your love of him so that you can love others as, you know, you love yourself. God bless you. Be encouraged as you go into the new year. Happy New Year. Happy holiday to you. I hope this blesses you. And please share it with others. And I hope you do subscribe to my channel.